.NET MAUI and Blazor are a match made in heaven. You probably already know about Blazor Hybrid, with which you can take your Blazor application, put it in a .NET MAUI app, and boom, you have this platform-native app, which is really amazing. But did you also already know about the Blazor Bindings, with which you can now not mix the C# code with HTML and CSS, but now you can mix your code with Blazor Syntax and actual .NET MAUI components? Let's take a little step back here. We now have basically three flavors how you can use .NET MAUI. So first is just use .NET MAUI, right? You're going to write probably XAML. You can do it in C# as well, but you will have everything translated from that abstract .NET MAUI layer to however it should look like on that platform, right? So that is great. That is like our original idea here. The second one is Blazor Hybrid. So with that, you can mix and match. You can have your full application as a hybrid application. You will just have that Blazor web view, in which you will load your complete Blazor application. You will need to do a little bit of CSS and HTML, and you will have that look, and you can still have that native application and reach out to all the platform APIs, right? So that makes it super powerful. You can reuse all your web skills, but still leverage all the power from the native platform. So that is really amazing. But now there is this third option, and actually it has been around for a little while, with which you can take the Blazor syntax. So if you've looked at Blazor before, then you know it kind of like goes back to the old ASP.NET days or PHP days, where you kind of like mix the logic with the markup. So you can do with the at sign, you can do a little bit of code, a little bit of C# code, then you mix in some HTML, you output, you do a little for each loop, and you output like the unordered list, right? That's the stuff that you can do with that. You can have a little code block in there. And that's what you can do with the Blazor bindings, but now you can do it with MAUI elements. So instead of having that H1 for the header in HTML, you can now put in that collection view or a label or whatever MAUI component is there. So you can leverage the Blazor syntax, but still get that native look and feel of your application, because it will still be translated as with using regular .NET MAUI, if you wish. So let's just stop talking about it and see how it actually works in practice. So this project, if you've heard of it before, we have an official experimental project that has been going on, but it hasn't seen a lot of development. So if we go here, we have it under github.com/.NET/mobile-blazor-bindings is what it's called. I'm surprised to see a little recent commit here, but there hasn't been any real development here. This is just an experiment. So if that's something that you're interested in, check it out. But this person right here, which is Dream Escaper Alexander from Ukraine, thank you so much for doing this. He is someone from the community who said like, hey, I like this idea and I want to take it further. So I'm going to take this project. I'm going to maintain it on a personal level, and I'm just going to move forward with it. So that is really great. And whenever something official comes, he says on his repository, like, I'm happy to contribute any progress that I've made. And this is how the best projects came to be, right? Come into the world. So that is amazing. Thank you so much for doing this, Alexander, right from this place. And he has now bumped this to version 1.0. So he is confident enough that you can actually do something with this, which is really amazing. Now, it's all open source, right? So you can all check it out. I will include the link down below in the video description. And there is some instructions on how to get started, right? So here we can see like the stack layout and the label, and we have that little code block. But this is not really that is officially and inside of Visual Studio right now. So what you want to do is install this manually. So you can open up a command line window. I have the Windows terminal here already with the right command. You could do .NET new install BlazorBindings.Maui.templates, and whenever you press enter here, that will be installed. So this is basically just a NuGet package that gets installed, but it contains templates. And you can see that we've now successfully installed the Maui Blazor Bindings app, and you can do short name Blazor Bindings Maui app. So if you want to do it from the command line, you can do .NET new Blazor Bindings Maui. So, right. So that's the name that you see here, basically Maui. And then you could give it a little name so that it goes to a new subfolder, test Blazor bindings, right? So you could do that. And now it's getting created, and we can get into change directory, CD test Blazor bindings. There we are. And if we inspect what's in here, then you can see the solution and whatnot, right? But if you just install the templates with that command line, we can also go to Visual Studio. So let me just do that now in presentation mode. So you get nice the big fonts and you can see all these things. And we go to create new project. And we can see here that we will have a new one, which is this Blazor Bindings template. You can see it has a little new tag on it. So you can just click that, MAUI Blazor Bindings app. Click next. So we got to name this. So let's do this MAUI Blazor Bindings sample. So that's kind of like the thing that I always use. You can find it in the GitHub, on my GitHub account. A sample repository will be there with all the stuff that I'm showing you today. And of course, as with anything, if there's anything more that you want to see a little bit more in depth, let me know down in the comments and I'll be sure to make a video on that. Now, hopefully I've talked long enough to actually generate this project. That's what Visual Studio did here in the background. And let's go to our Solution Explorer and we'll see something that looks familiar, but also something doesn't look familiar. So we have our platforms folder, right? So this is still what you get from .NET MAUI as well. We have all of our platform specific project, our Android, our metadata, Android manifest. For iOS, we have the info plist because that is needed to create a mobile app, right? So we have all that. We can write platform specific code right in here. But for the rest, you would typically see XAML files and now we see Razor files. So we have appshell.razor. What's up with that? And we have this little shell content. We have the main page in here. So that's kind of like following the same pattern as the default file new .NET MAUI application. We have a little app shell, which setups like the main page right here. But we also have like the main page, so the actual main page. And this looks different than the XAML pages, right? Because we have this at sign notation with which we register. If you've never seen Blazor before, this is how you register the root to an application, to a page. So you can just register your routes like this, and we're going to create a new page in a little bit, and you can just specify slash whatever, and that will be the URL, if you will, that you have to navigate to get to that new page. So that's how Blazor works. Now here we have this content page, a scroll view, a vertical stack layout, all stuff that you know from .NET MAUI, right? And it is the syntax highlighting is a little bit different. And what you can now do is here say, hey, at if, I can just write an if statement here. If true, then we're going to do this, right? We're going to actually show this label. And if not, we're not going to show this label. So you can just mix and match the markup with the logic here, if that's what you want. You can, of course, also come up with different things, but this is one thing that you can do right here. This is your Blazor syntax. So that is really cool. You can also see this padding. You can just create a new thickness right here. That's what's happening here. This is a short notation for new thickness, and you can create it like that. So you can just instantiate new objects from right here, something that you cannot do with XAML. Now, if we scroll down here a little bit, we can see here this button, which has a text. And now again, this at sign, this is really a key thing in Blazor. The at sign refers to the button text. And the button text is a string field, which we have a button text. And depending on the count, which we have here, it's going to have a little switch statement between if the value is zero, then it's going to say click me. If it's one, it's going to say click one time. And for all the other cases, it's going to say clicked count times, right? And we have our button, of course. Again, this is the same pattern as we have for the default file new .NET MAUI application. It mimics the same functionality here. We have this on counter clicked, which is, you know, referenced from here on click. And we do count plus plus. So we do that one and that automatically updates this. So it has a way to automatically detect all the things that are going on here. No, well, it technically is data binding, but no data binding, no iNotify property changed. It will just pick up those changes automatically. We have this image source right here, the .NET mod source. So we got that all in place. So if I run this, it doesn't have the default style in here that the .NET MAUI template has by default. So it's going to be a little less purple. that's mainly what that means. But we're going to see the exact same screen that we would have if you do a file new .NET MAUI application. I'm just going to run it on Windows because this is not really a concept that eats into like the platform specific stuff. If you have this working on Windows, it also runs on Android, iOS, all the platforms that are supported by .NET MAUI. And you can see this exact same thing. And if you do click me, you can see this button is clicking here and it's updating the actual caption here. So how amazing is that? Now, just to not show you this file new template thing right here, I also want to show you a little bit about a little bit deeper. But again, if you want to know more about some concepts here, let me know down in the comments. The one thing that I wanted to show you is how to do a little bit of navigation just to get you started. So let's add a new page right here. And in the Solution Explorer, I'm going to right-click on my project, and I'm going to say Add New Item. Now it comes up with a Razor component, which is technically correct. But in the templates, I don't think there is a specific .NET MAUI Razor component right here. So let's just call this, I don't know, subscribe page. Maybe you have a YouTube channel that you want to subscribe to, .Razor. So here we are. And this is going to add a regular Razor component, right? So this is going to be HTML, which is something that's going to blow up in runtime if we're not going to change this. So what I first want to do is say add page, and I'm going to do slash subscribe, right? So this is going to be the endpoint where I can reach my Razor page. We'll see that in a little bit. And then this has to be a page, right? So let's do content page, and in here, I'm just going to do a label. You can see the IntelliSense works. It's right here. It has all the properties, all the stuff for .NET MAUI. I'm going to say text subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Slash, maybe make the text a little bit bigger. So font size, I can just set that to, I don't know, 50. Let's make it something big. And we have a label in a content page. If I wanted to, I could write a little code here. I'm not going to do that right now. And if you want to navigate to this page, let's go to my Razor page for the main page. And I'm just going to reuse this on counter-clicked. And what you want to do is inject. So the way that dependency injection works for Blazor, again, you can do this multiple ways, but this is one of the ways. You can say add inject. And I'm going to say inject navigation, which is something that is automatically injected through whenever we enable this Blazor binding stuff. And this is then the name that you can reference it by. So this is the type, this is the name of my variable that I'm going to use. And I'm going to use that down here in my on counter clicked navigation.navigate to async, or you can do pop, or you can do pop modal, or pop doesn't make sense. Push is what I was gonna say. And then of course you can pop as well. So we have all the things right here, but you can also just do navigate to async. And here I can specify a couple of things, one of which is the URL, which is slash subscribe. I can just say that and it will go to there. And I can also do something with parameters. So add parameters in there so that you can use those in your new page. But right now I'm just going to go to my subscribe thing. Basically anything that you know from Blazor, you can reuse that now, but now with .NET MAUI component. So navigation, navigate to async. Technically what you want to do is then here do async task so that we don't do any funny stuff right here, and then await this one so that our async await is in check as well. So we got all that. One thing that I do wanted to show, which I skipped over, is this inject navigation, because if you also inspect the MAUI program.cs, this will, you know, mostly look the same as your regular .NET MAUI application. But here we have use MAUI app, which now has a Blazor Bindings application instead of the regular app that you would see here for .NET MAUI. And we have this use MAUI Blazor Bindings, which sets up all the fundamentals for using these Blazor Bindings, and one of which is registering this navigation object here so that you can use that for navigation in your application. So if I now run the Windows application again, I'm going to see that button, and now whenever I click that button, it should take me to this new page, which is very simple, but this is how you can get started with the navigation in the Blazor Bindings mobile app. And I see I have a typo here, subscribe to my channel, thank you, I've navigated to a new page. And that is what the Blazor mobile bindings is for .NET MAUI. Options, I like options. So now you have three options: regular .NET MAUI, .NET MAUI Blazor bindings, or the Blazor hybrid. There is something for everyone. Want to know more about any of these? Let me know down in the comments. Thank you again so much for watching. Please don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and maybe while you're here, check out this playlist for more .NET MAUI content. Check out this recommended video, which is recommended just for you, lovely viewer of this video, and I will be seeing you for the next one.